Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's discuss carbocation intermediates. So carbocations, I've drawn a number of carbocations across the top of this slide. There are four of them. Note that this first one has no other groups other than hydrogen attached to the positive carbon. And then we put one carbon group, and I drew a methyl just because it's quick to draw, but that could be an ethyl, it could be a propyl, it could be anything. And the next picture I drew two carbon groups on our positive carbon, and then finally we have three carbon groups. Now these types of carbocations have special names, and it creatively goes back to how many carbons are on the carbocation center. So the second one we call it a primary center. Sometimes we write that one with a degree sign. When we have two carbons on it, we call it secondary. Three carbon groups, surprise, we call it tertiary. Well, what do you think we call the first one? The first one we call, and this is so unsatisfactory to me, methyl. This is a methyl carbocation. And I want to always say, well, maybe it's 0 degree. No, it's not 0 degree. No one will say 0 degree. It's methyl and then primary, secondary, and tertiary. These carbocations have a stability trend. The methyl is the least stable of these four. Let's make that T clear. And the tertiary is the most stable of these four. And this goes back to something that we called in a different video, hyperconjugation. If you remember, the attached carbons and the bonds on these attached carbons, those electrons in those bonds can weakly overlap with our electron deficient carbon and help stabilize that carbocation. The more carbons we put around our carbocation, the more stable the carbocation becomes. This is a hyperconjugation effect. You can also have resonance to stabilize a carbocation. So now we're talking about what kind of effects will stabilize or affect the stability of this positive charge. Well, hyperconjugation is one. Resonance is common with almost all charges. So we can break this carbon-carbon pi bond, swing those electrons over towards the carbocation. And if we follow those arrows, we'll have a double bond on the right-hand side. This double bond is now gone. That leaves this carbon short of electrons. It has a positive charge. And then we can draw a resonance form. We have delocalized that charge between the two carbons. Furthermore, we would say, oh, this particular structure, this is a primary carbocation. The structure on the right is a secondary carbocation because this carbon is attached to two other carbons. So when we look at these two resonance forms, we'd say this would be the major contributor in our structure because this resonance form we'd expect would be more stable because it's a secondary carbocation rather than a primary carbocation. So this would be minor. We also can talk about inductive effects with carbocations. So here is a carbocation. This is a nice stabilized tertiary carbocation. The carbon has three attached carbon atoms. Now in this case, we exchange this carbon for a fluorine atom. That fluorine is going to have a polarized carbon sigma bond. That polarized bond is going to have a little bit of negative charge on fluorine, a little bit of positive charge on carbon, and in fact, this partial positive next to the positive of the carbocation, that's going to be destabilizing. So we'd say that this one, by the inductive effect, the one on the right is less stable, and the regular tertiary carbocation on the left is more stable, although this is also a tertiary carbocation. It just has a destabilizing inductive effect. So these are some of the general tools that we'll use when we talk about carbocations and evaluate which one may or may not be better as we try to work through a reaction pathway.